Hello. Welcome to this patient education video. Let's talk about atrial fibrillation. My name is Bonnie Quinlan, and I'm an advanced practice nurse in cardiology at the University of Ottawa Heart Institute. The objective of this video is to help you understand and learn more about atrial fibrillation. Specifically, I will be discussing the basics, such as the normal heart, and how atrial fibrillation is different. Common diagnostic testing done when your doctor believes you have atrial fibrillation, and medication and treatment options. I will then be discussing how stroke is related to atrial fibrillation and how your risk of stroke can be reduced. Lastly, I will be providing some tips about how you can live well with atrial fibrillation. Let's start by looking at the normal heart. Your heart is a muscle that works like a pump to move blood throughout your body. It has four chambers, two upper ones called the atria and two lower chambers called the ventricles. The right atrium and ventricle pump blood to your lungs to pick up oxygen. The left atrium and ventricle pump this oxygen-rich blood to the rest of your body through the arterial system. The pumping of the heart is regulated by an electrical current or impulse, like a spark plug in a car. The electrical impulse starts in the sinoatrial node, which we usually refer to as the SA node, the heart's natural pacemaker. The impulse then spreads throughout the right atrium and over to the left atrium, like ripples in a pond. This causes the muscles of the atria to contract and pump blood into the ventricles. The impulse then travels down to the atrioventricular node and through the bundle of His to the ventricles via the right and left bundle branches. This causes the muscle of the ventricle to contract and pump blood to the lungs from the right side of the heart and to the rest of the body from the left side of the heart. This is how the heart beats effectively. So how is atrial fibrillation different? You may hear your doctor refer to atrial fibrillation as AF or AFib. All these terms mean the same thing. It is just the way healthcare providers often shorten it. Atrial fibrillation is the most common form of heart rhythm disorder or arrhythmia. It affects 1 out of every 1,000 people less than 55 years of age, but affects 1 in 10 people older than 80 years of age. It is more common in people who have high blood pressure, coronary artery disease, heart valve problems, or heart failure. AF is a common rhythm problem with the upper chambers of the heart. Instead of the electrical impulse originating from the SA node, impulses originate from all over the atria, causing the heart to beat irregularly and sometimes too fast. Atrial flutter is similar to atrial fibrillation. However, the electrical impulses are more regular, but still cause the heart to beat in an irregular fashion. This type of arrhythmia is not as common as AF. The electrical impulses are more regular, but still rapid and inefficient. There are three types of atrial fibrillation: paroxysmal, persistent, and permanent. Let's review them. Paroxysmal AF is the type that comes and goes, but usually stops on its own within 48 hours. Often these episodes don't require treatment. Persistent AF is described as episodes that last longer than 7 days and usually do not stop without some type of treatment. And finally, permanent AF is when it is not possible to revert back to a normal rhythm. The goal of treatment is primarily managing symptoms through medications. If you are not sure which type of atrial fibrillation you have, please ask your doctor or healthcare provider. Many people live well with atrial fibrillation. An estimated 350,000 people in Canada alone have it. In most cases, if your AF is managed well, you can lead a normal life. Many people have very few symptoms during an AF episode, and others have uncomfortable feelings such as palpations, shortness of breath, dizziness, fatigue, and feeling anxious, sometimes even chest pain. Remember, if you are experiencing chest pain, it is important that you call 911. I will be reviewing more on what to do during an episode of atrial fibrillation later in this video. There are many risk factors for developing atrial fibrillation, such as having coronary artery disease, valve heart problems, lung disease, recent open heart surgery, any other type of heart rhythm problem, an abnormal heart structure, such as congenital heart disease, and just being over the age of 60. There are also some risk factors that are associated with atrial fibrillation that are modifiable, meaning that if you have these risks, it is important to control them, as this will help manage your AF. These modifiable risk factors are diabetes, high blood pressure, obesity, drinking more than 2 alcohol beverages per day, thyroid disease, and sleep apnea. If you would like more information on managing these risks, please speak with your doctor, and you can also refer to our Heart Healthy Living Guide.